Hello peeps, today I'm going to show you how to tie a 5 lead 8 byte Turk set. We are using the kind of braiding technique that I have shown you in the Spanish ring knot expansions, and this one goes back to the 5 lead 3 byte, and this way we do not start with the rounds building to the right, but we start as we start with a 5 lead 3 byte. And I'm going to show you now, just to show you that it's indeed the same process, but there are other versions of tying this that I show in another video. So we're starting with the 5 lead 3 byte process in this manner. Come out over the byte here, go round, and now we have to slip one over the other and come out over, and we need to go in under. So if I would have done it the other way around, it would not work. So in this case, you can see, come out over, and we have to go in under to lock this in. This is sort of, it's splitting the pairs, like in any other enlargement process for building bigger Turk's heads. So if we weave this in, go round, and meet up, we then have a 2, 4, 5, 1 byte, 2 bytes, 3 bytes Turk set, 5 lead 3 byte Turk set. Now we're gonna do this, and I'm going to show you how this is indeed the very same. When we're doing the bigger one, and you can enlarge this to the next one, 5 lead 13, 5 lead 18, and of course you would need a mandrel then, but you never need pins or anything like this. So we're coming out over, we do this, put this over again, and weave in again. Come under this, these, so, and again, we now have to do something with this pair here. You can see this is the pair, and I show you that you can easily see if you're right or wrong. So we come out over here, and if we put this over and this over, then we would have to go in over again, which would not lock anything in. You can easily see that this is wrong. So we put this one over that and create our path where we can lock in. That is the first one where we do this. And here, I'll turn this round. We do not have to do anything, just like in the Spanish ring knot, as in the Spanish ring knot expansions. The second time we just use what we find there. And you can see this one is comes under and has to be locked in by going under. And this one goes under. And here it comes out over again. Turning this round, so this is the last one already, and we know that we have to take our right one, pull this over, create our path, and here we go. And to finish it properly, we always have to go right to our standing part or beside our standing part. So, and you can easily see, of course you have to rearrange it a bit. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Or if you choose to do it like this, you take two of the side-by-side line strings and count all the things going in between. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, I hope you could follow. I hope you enjoyed. Thank you for watching.